Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Let us start this lecture with a thought process. Name and fame flickers like a flame which may douse any instant with a little gust of wind. So, in the last lecture, if you see that we basically looked at the ignition energy, types of ignition system one can think of, and then later on we found out a simplified relationship for the minimum ignition energy, and we have looked at like it will be dependent on the pressure, initial temperature, and then equivalence ratio, type of fuel air mixtures, kind of things. But now I will be giving you some evidence how it is changing, particularly from taking some experimental data, right. If look at, as I told that in the last lecture, we analyze basically the minimum ignition energy on a quiescent atmosphere. There is no velocity, but in real situation, for example, gas turbine engine, spark ignition engine, even in your LPG stove, it's not quiescent. It will be moving, right? Some velocity will be there. So that we'll have to look at it, and we are looking at effect of low velocity on ignition energy. And this is the energy is not really related to minimum ignition, it is about the energy which will be released whenever you apply some gap width between the spark electrode and certain pressure you will be giving, right. So, this is being shown here, that is the energy release versus the velocity. You can see that for all the cases, whatever the spark gap width is there, that is basically is increasing with the velocity, which is expected because some of the heat will be taken away. So, therefore, the heat release which will be affected by that, and when of course the gap is increasing, then it is basically energy requirement will be higher because the you will have to give some amount of energy, the voltage will be higher, and then you will have to give more amount of energy in the volume. So, if you take this data and then couch in the form of some empirical relationship, we will get IR 16 RED 0.15, D is the 0.85. This width is basically nothing but D, okay. And keep in mind that these R in IR is the ignition energy release in millijoules, RE is the Reynolds number based on using D as the length scale, right. And D is the spark gap, and this is a semi empirical result which will be utilized only for the range it is being experimented, it cannot be generalized, okay, that you should keep in mind. Let us look at the effect of velocity on the minimum ignition energy, right. Here the situation is like that, turbulence is 1%, very low turbulence, and equivalence ratio 1.0. And this is basically C3H8 air mixture, right, and pressure is 0.1 atmosphere, and that depends on the how this electrode, these are basically electrode, right, and flow is this way, like electrode are being arranged, it is what type of electrode, right, and this is a line itself like aligned with the flow, this is different. So, therefore, in this case the ignition energy, minimum ignition energy is higher, right, as compared to D is equal to 2 centimeter, right, both are same, but it is having. And however, you can note our main point is that minimum ignition energy increases with the velocity, right, it increases with the velocity, that indicates what we had seen earlier, but that is not minimum ignition, that is the energy will be released whenever you apply certain amount of voltage and current, right. And let us look at the effect of turbulent velocity on minimum ignition energy, and this is a is not experimental, some kind of a semi empirical relationship that I have taken. and u dash is the turbulent fluctuating velocities. It is something 0, 0.2 and 0.5 meter per second. This is very quite low turbulence level. And you can see, even though low turbulence level, the minimum ignition energy for any particular equivalence ratio, if you look at, there is an increase in the minimum ignition energy where the u dash goes on increasing from 0 to 1. And this is 0 means there is no turbulence at all, right, kind of things. So, you can see that it is basically minimum ignition energy is affected by the turbulence level. It is affected by the velocity, affected by the initial temperature, pressure and fuel air mixture and its ratio, type of fuel air mixture and its ratio means fuel air ratio, right. So, these are the things what we have discussed till now about ignition energy, and now we will be moving into the turbulent flame. So, till now we have discussed about basically laminar flames or the laminar premixed flame to be more particular. And because of fact that this is very fundamental, although the laminar flames are really used in application. Can you tell me where we use laminar flame in application wise? LPG burner you can consider to be laminar, but actually it is a jet. So, generally there will be some turbulence, but you can consider that as a laminar approximately. Otherwise, other places like it will be basically turbulent being imparted in the combustors because of fact that they want to release the heat at a very higher rate, right. So, therefore, it is being used. Of course, nowadays people are talking about micro combustors where the laminar flame will be there, right. And this is of course, application is not that very predominant or not being used that much, but however, it will be there. But we discuss too much on the laminar premixed flame because that is fundamental to even turbulent flame. So, therefore, it is, and in practical application like your gas turbine application, spark ignition engine, furnace and other burners, right, industrial burners, the turbulence is being utilized intentionally, right, to enhance the flame stability and also the release, the heat release at a higher rate. So, if you look at the turbulence, basically what happens when you use the turbulence, you will be having certain eddies and then that helps in mixing the things, and there will be fluctuating velocities which will be there. So, mixing occurs due to the random motion of eddies, which we had discussed the eddies earlier, right. And as a result, the mixing will be good and it will be affecting the flame surface, right. And as a result, the flame will be very convoluted kind of things. And it affects the flame propagation rate, that is a very important, right. But however, it is being talked about that it does not affect the chemical kinetics. But however, in recent time there is a contest in this, people, some people are saying that it does affect the chemistry under certain regime, right. It is not a universal statement what people are believing, but this is the recent one which is not a part of your textbook kind of thing, which is all debatable. So, that is we can you know keep in mind. And as I told that turbulent flames are random or the chaotic in nature, right, because of what? Because of eddies, and eddies will be of various kinds, large eddies, small eddies, medium scale eddies. We have talked about various scales like integral scale, like Kolmogorov scale, Taylor microscales, all kinds of scales we have had already discussed. So, those scales will be different. So, therefore, the vortex sizes will be different and it will be very violent in this nature. So, as a result, what will happen? That instantaneous flame front is highly corrugated or the convoluted, unlike the flame in case of laminar flame, you might have seen, I have shown you some picture, very, very smooth, very sleek, but here it is not. So, it will be very much a corrugated kind of surface you will get. Like for example, if you take any one line, this will be corrugated. For example, if I draw that here, it is not the way I am drawing, it will be very zigzag kind of thing, this is a corrugated, right. So, this flame is not as smooth as this looks to be, right. So, this is the features because of AEDs, it will be violent, it will be trying to make this flame surface to be wrinkled, right. And this flame surface will be changing its position with respect to time rapidly and randomly, right. It will be very fast, right. And also, so as a result, what will happen when you take an image of the flame, turbulent premixed flame, particularly Bunsen flame, what we are talking about now, you will find that it looks to be a very thick flame, right. And why? Because of fact that this all this thing, this we call it basically flamelet, right. And this is at any instant of time, but when you take image, you will be taking certain time, you know, like when you take this image in a high speed photograph, then you will get some corrugated shape, right. Otherwise, in general camera you would not get, or in your naked eyes you would not see. You say it looks to be smooth, no, that is not smooth. So, this is, we call it as basically a flame brush, because if I consider this, you know, all these images you are looking at one stroke, there might be several of them, right, right. And this inner one and outer one, what you will be seeing, right, in the flame, that we call a virtual turbulent flame thickness. The actual flame will be very thin, but you are getting this thickness. For example, thickness here, it will be like that, higher, right. And this is virtual, because of you can't see it in your naked eyes, except very high speed, you know, imaging, we can see that. So, but laminar flamelets, as I told, it is a instantaneous reaction zone. Laminar flamelet, as I told, one of them, let us say red color, I have shown any one of them, right, will be instantaneous reaction zone. So, now when you talk about basically turbulent flame, there will be various regimes, right. And now it can be broadly divided into four categories. Right, that does not mean only four categories, okay. There will be several varieties also in between, right. So, this turbulence one will be weak turbulent flame, other is will be wrinkle laminar flame, that means it will be wrinkling the flame surface, but it is laminar in nature, right, and flamelet in eddies and distributed reaction zone. Now, question arises, we have talked about it, but how we are going to basically divide into four categories. If you look at, like we have already looked at that, I mean, what are the variables when you talk about turbulent flame, what are the variables which affect the turbulent flame, right? Any idea? Of course, you can think of various length scales, right, okay. Also velocities, when you talk about velocities, right, it will be the fluctuating quantities that will be affecting, right, yes or no. For example, if I say that fluid is having fluid is turbulent, right, or the velocity is turbulent, I can talk about time here, and this is your velocity is here, I can, right, some velocity fluctuation, right, and this is nothing but your V x, I can say if it is this x with respect to time, right. I am talking about one dimensional like flame. Now, there will be some average velocity, right. If I take this with respect to time, I will be more interested to look at what is the average, right. This is my average velocity V. Right. So, if you look at this is V is equal to or V x is equal to V x average plus V dash. Now, this V dash is changing with respect to time, but which will be affecting the flame? Is it V average or V x or V dash? It will be V dash which will be affecting the flame surface, because that is the fluctuation. If you look at this is basically what is this V x, or this is V x dash. V x dash, what is the V x dash? I can talk about this is the V x dash, right? And it is respect to time. Then how I will consider, right? What I will have to do? I will have to define a RMS velocity. V dash RMS will be basically root over V dash square x, I can say, because I am talking about x, or right? Are you getting? Average, root mean square. This is root mean square velocity fluctuating, right? The component. So, that means this will be function, basically turbulent flame will be function of V dash RMS. Then what are the length scale we have talked about? One is integral scale or Taylor micro scale. Another we will be talking about Kolmogorov scale, LK. Beside this, it will be function of what? It will be of course the laminar bending velocity. It will be also dependent on the flame, laminar flame thickness, and it will be also dependent on the properties like kinematic viscosity, right? Nu is the kinematic viscosity, because these are whatever the laminar will be considering, and also will be considering the turbulence, whatever. So now when you talk about that, this basically you will be looking at the Reynolds number for turbulent flame, and that is nothing but your RE based on the integral scale or the Taylor micro scale. Integral scale and Taylor micro scale, L naught is equal to V dash RMS L naught, right, into nu. And this if you look at, then that is the Reynolds number, because it will be very difficult to consider all those things, but you can put into a non-dimensional form to understand what is happening. So, chemical reaction time I can define as delta L by SL. We have already looked at that, you know, because that is nothing but your time in which the chemical reaction, this is the L length, delta L is basically flame thickness, right? Flame means flame thickness of what? It is a laminar flame thickness, right? And SL is the laminar bending velocity, right? This is laminar bending velocity. So, we will be also defining another time scale, that is turbulence mixing time, right? And that is nothing but your Tm is equal to L naught divided by V dash RMS, right? Root mean square velocity, fluctuating velocities, right? And that will be talking about like how much this ADs will be taking time to get mixed, kind of things like with the VRMS other thing. And we can also define another non-dimensional number considering the chemical reaction time and turbulent mixing time, that we call it as a Damkohler number, right? Damkohler number is basically Tm divided by Tch, and which is I have already using this chemical reaction time, nothing but delta L by SL, and this is L naught divided by VRMS dash, right? And I can write down this as basically L naught by delta L divided by the VRMS by SL. And this is, if you look at, this is basically length scale ratio. And this is the term one can look at is the how far the root mean square velocity is different than the burning velocity. This is, you can say that velocity ratio, right. Now, we are now what we are defining, we are basically talking about the Reynolds number and Damkohler number, like you know from these variables. And we can look at what really happening, because can we combine this Reynolds number and Damkohler number together and see what we are getting. If I say this is Re L naught into dA is nothing but your RMS L naught by nu into I can say this is L naught, right, L naught SL by delta naught V dash RMS, right. So, this V RMS will cancel it out and we can get is basically L naught and L naught SL, you know L naught square is coming. Now, we know this is not delta, this will be L, okay. We can also express in terms of the SL in terms of flam length thickness. We know that SL, right, SL is equal to basically 4 by 3 alpha by SL, right. No, sorry, SL is equal to 4 by alpha by delta L, right. Yes or no? So, now we can write down this as basically Re L naught dA is nothing but your L naught square, right, and L naught square in SL I am putting it this value. So, this is 4 by 3 alpha by delta L into 1 by delta L, right. So, yes or no? So, this is basically I can say 4 by 3 there is a nu will be coming, okay, nu will be in down, right. So, you can say alpha by nu, right, and there is a L naught square by delta L square. So, if I take a root over of that, right, root over that, then it shows that is proportional to L naught by delta L, right. That means, what it indicates, if this is a very high values root over Re L naught dA naught, if it is a very high values, let us say something 10 power to the 3 to 10 power to the 4, right, what happens, right, it will be very high means what, like L naught will be much higher than the flame thickness, the ADs will be very large, right, and that will be affecting basically the flame shape, right. For example, if I say this is my flame, right, and this is the ADs which will be there, which is having a distance of L naught. So, it will be corrugating the flame, but it won't be affecting the chemical reaction. So, this is known as wrinkle laminar flame, right, linked laminar flame. In this case, what I am saying, the length scale is much greater than the delta L. There might be a situation where length scale, right, is very very less, it is order of or it is length scale is less than the delta L. Then what will happen? There might be a flame here, the ADs will be, these are ADs, right, which will be smaller than the flame thickness. This is basically delta L, right. So, this is not small scale and other things. So, that will be affecting the mix flame thickness, right? In the flame inside, it will be affecting because of it may affect also the chemistry because the mixing will be very higher here, right? So, this is another thing which is called flame eddies, eddies in flame, right? Eddies in flame. Right. So, now we will have to, I think I missed one point, let us look at that. There is a Damkeler number when it is higher, right. So, if Damkeler number is greater than 1, very, very higher values, what it indicates? That means this is length scale is very, very higher and then the chemical reaction time. That means chemical reaction time is much smaller, right, than the mixing time, means the chemistry will be very fast, right? It will be instantaneously, as soon as it will mix, it will reacting, will reaction will be taking place. So, if the Damkeler number is very, very small than 1, then that means the mixing is faster, the length scale ratio is much higher as compared to the velocity ratio, or in other words, the mixing time is much very, very small as compared to the chemical time, right. So, that is Damkeler number less than 1, fast mixing regime, right. And this is, if you look at the fast chemistry, this will be thin flame, flame will be very thin, right, as compared to what? As compared to the size of eddies, which will be affecting the flame. And based on this, what happened is basically about the people have divided the various regime, and that is a diagram which is being talked about to divide these flames. And as I told that turbulent flame, right, flame is basically function of what? I have already told, let me summarize it, L naught, that is the Reynolds number based on the integral scale, Damkeler number, right. Then I can talk about V RMS by SL, right. And I will talk about another scale which we had not considered, but we will talk about is Kolmogorov scale, right, that is LK by delta L. And there is, of course, we have already considered integral scale by the delta L flame thickness. So, these are the variables which based on which we can have this diagram where we will delineate the various regimes of the flame. And the plot is basically Damkeler number against the Reynolds number and a log-log plot which I have shown here, right, and depicts various regimes of turbulent planes. If you look at the weak turbulence will be occurring here, where Damkeler number is very high, right, but whereas the Reynolds number is small. This is the region, right, these are the regions where we are talking about weak turbulence, right. And this is the upper region of Borgidam, and this region where VRMSSL is around 10 power to minus 2 and LK by this thing is equal to 1, right, in this region is basically wrinkled laminar flame where the Damkeler number is moderate, but Reynolds number is very high regime, like it is from high to low. And in this regime from LK by in this wrinkled laminar flame, chemical reaction takes place in a thin reaction zone, right. The kinetics is very, very fast, right. The size of the eddies will be larger. But this zone is the flamelet in eddies, which will be basically LK by delta L is equal to 1 to L naught divided by delta L is equal to, in this regime it takes flame. And reaction zone is this regime may have several non-combustion zones, right, means there will be some holes in the combustion, in the reaction zone, because that will be quenching the flame locally. And some places it will be there. So, reaction zone won't be there. So, right, and there is a very important one, the distributor reaction zone, where which will be taking place at the low Lennard's number and low Damkohler number. And this is a regime below the L naught by delta L and distributed reaction zone, but this is not practically achieved, right? Reaction seats are distributed in the turbulent flame surface, and but however, people are thinking if they could devise a you know, combustors or a burner in this regime, that will be very good because it can have a higher heat release, and also the people are expecting that the emissions will be reduced. So, but this is not that easy to really establish in practical situations. With this, I will stop over. We will be discussing about in the next lecture about various aspects of the turbulent flames. Thank you very much.